Equity Market Update, July 2021. Indian equities traded within a range during the month, and Nifty 50 ended approximately 0.3% higher compared to the last month. Movement in equities was influenced by sequential improvement in domestic and global activity, better than expected Q1 FY22 results, rise in metal prices, etc. This was weighed down by rise in oil prices, rise in COVID-19 cases due to Delta variant, clampdown of Chinese authorities on technology and education companies, etc. Mid-caps and small-caps significantly outperformed the large-caps during the month. Sectoral performance was mixed, as metals, capital goods, information technology and healthcare delivered positive returns, while auto, power and oil and gas ended the month in negative. Global equities performance was mixed, with most major indices in US and Europe ending the month in positive, while in Asian markets like Japan, China, Hong Kong, etc. delivered a negative return. FPI sold net equity worth $1.5 billion in July 2021. On a cumulative basis, FPIs have sold net equity of $0.9 billion in the first 4 months of FY22, vis-a-vis $4.9 billion in the same period last year. Flows into domestic equity-oriented mutual funds remained steady at INR 9,060 crores in June 2021, compared to INR 11,845 crores a month ago. In Q1 FY22, domestic mutual funds have recorded net inflows of over INR 25,000 crores compared to net inflows of approximately INR 6,250 crores Q1 FY21. Out of the Q1 FY22 results declared so far, results of metals, cement, life insurance and large banks have been better than expected, whereas results of utilities, oil and gas, pharma and real estate have been largely in line with expectations. Results of auto, consumer staples and consumer durables were lower than expectations. Market rally becomes broad-based in CY21. While the rally in CY21 on back of considerable growth in CY20 has surprised many, but one should view the same in context that 10-year and 15-year CAGR returns from Nifty 50 have been largely in line with nominal GDP returns over the same period. Further, during CY18 to CY20, the rally in Nifty 50 was narrow, with top 5 stocks accounting for bulk of the returns. However, the rally in CYTD21 has become broad-based, reflected in contribution of top 5 stocks, reducing considerably. Also, the falling share of market capitalization of Nifty 50 compared to total market capitalization reflects that the broader market is outperforming the Nifty 50. Early signs of market excesses. Rising retail participation. Over the past few months, there has been a sharp increase in the non-institutional activity in equity markets, indicating the rising participation of retail investors. Interestingly, the intra-settlement trading as a percentage of cash volumes has also risen sharply over the past few months and now near all-time highs. Large IPO pipeline. The forthcoming IPO pipeline is strong, and over INR 1,500 billion value of issuance are likely over the next few quarters. Narrowing pockets of undervaluation. While there are still some pockets where valuations are below long-term average, the gap has reduced considerably over the past few months. Outlook. As on 31st July 2021, Nifty 50 was trading near 19.4x, FY23E price-to-earnings ratio. In view of the low interest, rate environment, and healthy earnings growth outlook, these multiples look reasonable. However, on an overall basis, the valuation of equity market is no longer cheap, with market cap to GDP at 92% and the gap between 10-year G-Sec and 1-year forward Nifty 50 earning yield at 1.5%, inching close to its long-term average of 1.7%. Further, 10-year and 15-year CAGR of Nifty 50 is now closer to the nominal GDP growth, and thus going forward over the medium to long term, returns from equities should be largely in line with overall economic growth. Additionally, the sharp rally in equities over the past 6 months has reduced the pockets of undervaluation considerably, and most sections of the markets appear reasonably valued. Also, while the corporate earnings growth outlook for FY22 is strong, it is likely to track long-term nominal growth from FY23 onwards. In view of the above, in our opinion, while markets hold promise over the medium to long term, one should moderate the returns expectations in line with the expected growth in nominal GDP. We remain optimistic on the economy and equity markets over the medium to long term, given the fall in COVID-19 cases and relaxations in restrictions, easy financial conditions and low cost of capital, comfortable external sector, supportive monetary and fiscal measures, improvement in corporate profitability, etc. Resurgence of spread of COVID-19, premature unwinding of fiscal and monetary stimulus, sharp increase in US yields, higher than expected NPAs, etc. are key risks in the near term. Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Read all scheme-related documents carefully.